We're up in Ankeny, Iowa at Carl's Performance and Hot Rods Racing. Here are some of the cars on display at Carl's. Just one of many rooms of custom cars. This is the upholstery shop. Has a tube frame underneath. Another room of cars.
You know when you play like that, there's no way out of me. I try to hold out, try to hang tough. We both know that I ain't got a friend. Thank you.
Jim's air conditioning. Good evening, everybody. We're going to get things started back here this evening. We appreciate you all coming out. On behalf of Carl and Penny Moyer and the entire Moyer family, Carl Chevrolet and Carl Performance, we want to welcome you to the 10th anniversary of Corvettes at Carl. We're glad y'all decided to come back this evening. We moved everybody inside so we can all stay cool tonight. I'm gonna let Carl kick it off with a few words. We've got a couple special guests with us this evening after Carl. We have Ken Lingenfelder here this evening, as well as Todd Christensen from Corvette Performance Marketing. So, Carl.
First of all, I want to thank everybody that made the trip. Some of you made the trip a little further than others, and it means an awful lot to me. There's a lot of familiar faces here and quite a few new faces. And when you look around, it's really hard to believe this crowd. And I know that everybody's here to have fun. Tomorrow, everybody's looking forward to that. It's gonna be at the racetrack. And I hope you're all enjoying yourself. This is a deal that, in my heart, is where this all comes from. I enjoy the people, the smiles. It makes me have a good time when you're having a good time. So I hope everybody's having a good time and enjoying themselves. Tony mentioned that we've got some special guests here with us, and he mentioned Todd Christensen from Corvette Performance. Todd's here, he's gonna say a few words. Ken Lingenfelder is here, who's, I'm sure that all of you folks know who the Lingenfelder family is and what they do. Also, we have Bill Elbert here. He's the fellow right there. He's the zone manager for us in this area right here. And we've got Vince Balabusi. Here he is right over there. Vince is our district manager. So, you know, we're pretty lucky to have the crowd of pretty high up people here with us to share this event. I'm tickled to death to have them all. So with that, if you don't mind, Todd, I'm gonna turn the mic over to you.
Sure. Great. Thanks, Carl. Congratulations on 10 years, this is great. So Todd Christensen, so I'm with Chevrolet, the factory from Detroit, just flew in today. Honored to be here. Carl's, I tell you, is no better ambassador for the Chevy brand and for Corvette Performance, and it's really great to be here to share this day with you and the team here. So it's also fun to share with a bunch of Corvette fans. I think there's one or two here. Anyone? All right, okay, let's get it up. So, listen, thanks for your passion in Corvette and all that you guys do. We can't do what we do without people like you that out there, obviously buying the cars, but supporting the brand, enjoying the passion that you do as enthusiasts. The Corvette team tries to get out to events like these a couple of times a year. We learn a lot from you guys. We like to tell you some things, but we really like to hear some things too. A lot of what we learn from you guys makes their way into future product. I'm not just saying that, this is really truthful stuff. So it's really, really helpful for us to hear from you guys. I was gonna tell you two things. One of them, we brought the C7R race car. It's out front. If you didn't see it, go check it out. Any race fans here? Okay, good. You guys all watch the IMSA series? Watch the two yellow cars go on the weekend? All right, good. Well, so they're racing Lime Rock tomorrow. The number three car is in the Drivers' Championship and the Team Championship right now, so it's been a pretty tough season, but they're fighting it out. And if you don't watch this kind of racing, it's pretty incredible stuff. We race in the IMSA series and the GT Le Mans class for a reason. We're right up against Porsche, Ferrari, Ford GT, Aston Martin sometimes. All the competitors that we compete with on the showroom are the same ones that we compete against on the weekend on the racetrack. So that's important. Those are pretty incredible competitors too. So when we have a chance to go beat those guys, it means a lot, right? That shows what the power of Corvette can do. There's a lot of people out there that still don't really know a lot about us. So when they see us on track, beating some of those high-end performance and sports cars means a lot to the brand. The other thing though, we use racing a lot to learn and make improvements to the car. So I won't go too far, but I can talk to you guys individually about it later. But if you look at the C7R and if you looked at past race cars, and just for example, take a look at some of the aero packages. So you see like vents and scoops and things coming out of the hood. All that stuff looks pretty similar to all you C7 owners, right? You guys all have hood air extractors. You guys all have vents coming out of the fenders. You've got vents coming out of the rear quarters. All that stuff really was learned from the C5R and C6R racing program. That's exactly the aero packages that we used to use to manage aero for either downforce or to help the path for cooling certain components on the car. So it's real deal stuff. Tad Schuchter, you guys know, chief engineer at Corvette, he's very close in connection with Pratt Miller, who runs the race team. It's a really symbiotic relationship. So it's real deal stuff and it makes your cars better. So with that, I'll be around all afternoon. Love to talk to you guys. Come up and say hi. Go out and see the race car. But again, thanks, Carl, for all you do. Thanks for being fans. And I'll hand it over to Ken.
Thanks, Todd. Carl, thanks again for the invite here. I'm truly honored to be here. I'm also real excited to be around Corvette people. Needless to say, I'm one of the more passionate guys on the Corvette side. We've been building performance cars for 45 years, and the majority have been Corvettes. I think I'm getting around to a lot of Corvette events around the country. And I'm more energized every time I go. I really enjoy this one. I've been to this one several times, and the day at the track tomorrow, if you haven't done it, you're gonna have a very good time. Carl puts on a really good show there. The thing is that I love this stuff so much, and I'm so passionate about it, that a lot of my friends think I need psychiatric help. The fact is that I think I like being here because all you guys get it. And so I feel very, very comfortable. General Motors is making some amazing products. We would be nothing without the Corvette and the Camaros and the quality of those vehicles when they come from the factory. Hats off to them. And I'm just excited to be a part of all of this, part of tonight, tomorrow. And thanks again, Carl, for the invite. And I'm just really honored to be here. By the way, there are very few people that we would trust in the country to put our parts on cars for customers. We're very proud that Carl works with us and very trusting in the fact that they do a great, great job here at the shop and everything else. So thanks again. Appreciate being here.
One thing I forgot, and the poor little guy, Ben, he's new. That's the reason I forgot him. But what I also forgot is his last name. So right there, he's another General Motors district manager. Say hi to Ben. Sorry about that, Ben. I owe you one, buddy.
All right, thank you, Carl, Todd, Ken. Just a few notes. Tonight's a celebration. It's the 10th anniversary event for us, as we said at the beginning of the night. We're highlighting the history, performance of an American icon, obviously the Corvette, all of your guys' passion for that vehicle. Tonight we're gonna have a great ambassador of the Carl brand, who's been a partner with Carl as well, Jason Brown, and a member of his band, Greg Valentine, sing for y'all tonight. About 8 o'clock, what we're gonna do, there's a raffle box out in the showroom. We're going to raffle off some great Corvette prizes that you see up here at the end of the night and close the evening that way. So stick around, enjoy some music, some food, some drinks. We're inside, so we're not gonna sweat it out tonight. But sit back and enjoy. And for those of you that we'll see tomorrow, we'll see you at the track, and we'll wrap up about 8 o'clock.
Can't afford a boat. All right, well, this song goes to you three people. Another one of my songs. It's called We're All in the Same Boat.
We all find bait, that same little place, south of the Cane Creek Marina. We load up on outs the beer that we like, Slim Jim's pork rinds and peanuts. Back up and down the ramp, tired, losing, jumping, head off to our favorite home. We all might be strange, but with these rings on our fingers, we're all in the same boat. We're all hiding from women out here in the open, drinking like fish on the water. And rangers and crisscross, pontoons and two rest, kicking back, watching them bobber. When our wives get calling, our buds will be howling. Ain't ever less to get home. And we'll be pulling in trailers and cussing like sailors. We're all in the same boat.
Yes, we are.
We're from all walks of life, but afraid of our wives. That ball, that chain, that shack. So before they wake up, we sneak out to our trucks, head up Saint Creek, no paddle. When in mind that we're fishing, they'll be mad as a didn't, and them honey, I'm sorry's won't go. We'll be sleeping on couches in different doghouses. We're all in the same boat. We're all hiding from women out here in the open, drinking like fish on the water. In rangers and Chris cracks, pontoons and two rests, kicking back, watching them bob. When our wives keep calling, our butts will be howling. Ain't ever less to get home. And we'll be pulling trailers and cussing like sailors. We're all in the same boat. Yeah, we're all hiding from women out here in the open, drinking like fish on the water. In rangers and crisscross, pontoons and two breasts, kicking back, watching and bobbing. When our wives get calling, our butts will be howling. Ain't double S to get home. And we'll be pulling them trailers and cussing like sailors. We're all in the same boat. And we'll be pulling them trailers and cussing like sailors. We're all in the same boat.
Yeah.
My blood runs on the side like a mighty Mississippi, Yankee Doodle Dandy, and I sing Dixie. Thank you.
the garages and everyone's got a chair. We didn't get up early enough to get into a garage ourselves. Going to a driver's meeting.
Good morning, everybody. Thanks for coming out. How's everybody doing?
Great!
Woo! It's not so hot yet, right?
Yeah.
First off, I want to thank the Iowa Speedway for having us this morning and this afternoon. On behalf of Carl and Penny Moyer, Carl Chevrolet, and Carl Performance, again, we welcome you to the 10th anniversary of Corvettes at Carl. Today's our track experience all day long. So, first off, I want to recognize some folks that are standing in the back. If you were with us last night, we recognize these guys, but we've got our friends here in Des Moines from General Motors, Bill Elbert, who's our zone manager, Vince Belfusi, Ben and Steve from General Motors, and then we have Todd Christensen with us here for most of the day today from Corvette Marketing. So, welcome those guys. If you see them walking around, bend their ear. They've got a lot of knowledge on Corvette. So, and we're happy to have them with us today. Before I get into my roles and timelines, what I want to do is I want to have Luke come up from the Iowa Speedway. He's going to go through some of the safety things today with his team, how his team's going to work today, work with you guys on the track if something would happen. Hopefully we don't need any of that, but I'm going to let him start the day, and then we'll get into the details, and then we'll try to get out of here and get rolling. So,
thank you, Tony. 10 years, I see a few familiar faces over the years. So how many people have been here before? All right. How many people have never been here? Okay. Well, basically, the way this works is you guys are going to be behind the pace car. Most of you know that. It's basically follow the leader, no passing. If you have a mechanical issue, they do happen occasionally, just pull down to the low side of the track and there'll be a truck there to assist you. We'll decide what we need to do. I think Amber is gonna be following everybody. There'll be the pace car in the front. Scott over there, you driving the pace car this morning, Scott?
Jeff's
gonna do it?
Jeff,
okay.
Mark and I.
They're gonna rotate throughout the day, sounds good. Is there any questions? If you happen to go in the gravel trap, don't feel bad. It happens once in a while.
Yeah.
Just stay in your car until somebody gets there. So, unless it's on fire. Hopefully that doesn't happen either. So, yes, sir.
I know this probably won't happen. What if a guy lost control and hits your car? How did the insurance work on that?
Good luck. What insurance?
Insurance.
Don't answer the question.
I know we got an attorney in here. Brad?
I can answer it. I checked with Haggerty, which I have 5 Corvettes, and I have them all through them. Not covered out here.
Because it's a racetrack.
Yep.
So just know that.
I'm not. I had to get race day insurance.
It's a
special you got to get special coverage.
If he crashed, can you just tow it out by the highway?
If you do have a wreck, we can load the car up. Hopefully, we don't have to do that. We hate to see that happen to nice vehicles. So. Anyway, you know, just be careful, guys. Make sure your seatbelts are on, and don't get too aggressive out there. I mean, have some fun. That's what this is about. But don't get too crazy. We don't want to wreck vehicles. That's not why we're out here.
Is a vet.
silver vet with red pinstripes. You don't see very many of them around anymore either. Those are citations. I saw aluminum the other day. Remember the Brett? Yeah. I remember when I got a Brett GT, I thought I was it, man. 3.8 GT. Then it came out with the GTCs with the ground effects. That's pretty hot. 1989. I was like 10 at the time. So here's a song we put out last year to radio. You might have heard it, you probably did. Here we go, it's called Old Soul. Taste the trail.
This is the lineup for Carl's breakfast, Saturday morning. We'll be right back. This is Carl's Collection.
You're always on my mind. We'll be right back.
This is Denny Abog's collection.
Black trumpet, I'm in trouble. Black trumpet, I see trouble. Man, 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 how am I gonna get home? Black trumpet, I'm so driven. Black trumpet, please get driven. Oh, 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 help me to get home. Black trumpet, I'm in trouble. I'm so driven. Please get driven. Man, 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 man. I'm not gonna get home. Black trumpet, I'm in trouble. I'm so driven. Please get driven. Oh, 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 oh. Now I'm not gonna get home.
a Z06, 1963, with a 36-gallon tank.